Sometime in the not so distant future, you may find it quite difficult to spot the difference between male and female athletes. Worried that muscular women or those with naturally elevated levels of testosterone, the hormone that increases muscle mass, strength and oxygen carrying capacity, will dominate the future, International Association of Athletics Federation President, the former 1500 meter British gold medalist Sebastian Coe, in 2018 passed new laws for 400, 800 and 1500 meter events.
Women with naturally elevated levels of testosterone must either reduce them, change their event, or compete with men.
28-year-old Caster Semenya's biology has been under scrutiny for a decade, ever since she burst on the scene at the 2009 World Track and Field Championships in Berlin, winning gold. With fellow competitors like Italian Elisa Kusma, who finished 6th in the same race, calling her
a man.
She was subjected to sex tests following her victory. Found to have naturally elevated levels of testosterone, she was initially banned by the athletics top body from competition for 11 months. While Semenya's testosterone levels are not publicly known, most women, including elite female athletes, have natural testosterone levels of between 12 to 61 nanograms per deciliter of blood, while an adult male's testosterone levels at peak are much higher, 295 to 1150 NGDL. IAAF's new law classified any female athlete with testosterone levels of over 145 as intersex athletes, aka DSD, or differences of sexual development, who would be compelled to take hormone suppressing drugs to reduce and maintain their testosterone levels to below 145 NGDL for 6 months before competing. Cleared after her initial suspension in 2011, Semenya returned to win the 800-meter silver medal in the 2012 London Olympics, which later got bumped up to gold after the winner, Russia's Maria Savionova, was found guilty of doping. Where world records are broken by a tenth of 1 second, Semenya dropped her timing by as much as 7 seconds, winning the 800-meter gold again at the 2016 Rio Olympics. By early 2019, Semenya's matter had reached the Swiss-based Court of Arbitration for Sport, CAS, who in a 165-page 2-1 decision upheld IAAF's ruling to ban DSD women from 400, 800 and 1500 meter events. CAS's verdict had to weigh fair play among women athletes against human rights and also address complaints of racism. Paula Radcliffe, former British marathoner, feels to have done nothing would have risked losing the next generation of female athletes.
Countries will only select girls with elevated testosterone levels.
A study by Gina Kolata, twice a Pulitzer Prize finalist, writer for the New York Times and author of 6 books, showed women athletes with high testosterone levels won 30 medals in Olympic and World Championship races in the 400 to 1500 meter events.
While only 1 in 20,000 have naturally high testosterone levels, all 3 medal winners at the 2016 Rio Olympics had higher than normal levels.
Francine Niyonsamba of Burundi, who finished second to Semenya, publicly confirmed earlier this year,
"I too have naturally elevated levels of testosterone."
While third place Kenya's Margaret Wambui, also with naturally high levels, criticized CAS's decision.
"Testosterone lowering medicine will have side effects that will limit our ability to compete."
IAAF's suggestion that DSD athletes compete with men is also absurd. In 2017, Dorian Coleman reviewed the best performances of 3 normal female athletes who were the fastest 400 meter runners in history.
"Over 10,000 men and boys beat the best times these women ever ran."
With her timing, Semenya would not have even qualified for the heats of the men's 800 meters at the Rio Olympics, where the lowest timing was 1 minute 53.41 seconds against Semenya's fastest ever timing of 1 minute 55.45 seconds. Many support the outlawed athlete. Madeline Pape, former Australian Olympian who once raced and lost against Semenya, has changed her thinking.
"I think it's hard to draw a biological line around female athlete category."
The World Medical Association too disagreed with CAS on whether Semenya gained an unfair advantage.
"This is based on weak evidence from a single study, which is currently being widely debated by the scientific community."
IAAF's previous attempt to regulate testosterone in female athletes was scuttled by India's Dati Chand in 2014, who failed a sex test and was not allowed to participate in the 2014 Glasgow Commonwealth Games. Appealing to the CAS, she successfully challenged IAAF's 2011 hyperandrogenism regulations for 100s and 200s. As expected, she supports Semenya.
She did not get justice. Some girls are 5 feet and some are over 6 feet. Is that a level playing field?
Dr. Pioshni Mitra, one of 10 expert witnesses who testified on behalf of Semenya at the CAS in Lausanne, still believes.
It's her hard work, not genetic quirk, that makes her a winner.
Through the hearing, she set an alarm for 5:10 a.m. every day, trained hard, then sat in court all day and was back training again in the evening. Brave in the face of a career-ending verdict, both Semenya and Wambui began competing in races outside of the CAS's 400 to 1500 meter verdict. Semenya's in 2000 and 5000, Wambui in the 100 and 200s. Supported by Athletics South Africa, where she is a national hero, Semenya appealed CAS's decision, but was not really expecting a favorable outcome.
God made me the way I am. I will once again rise above and continue to inspire young women and athletes.
Before the appeal could be heard, however, Switzerland's top court, the Federal Tribunal, stayed implementation of the new law.
We have issued a super provisional order temporarily superseding the CAS ruling.
Whatever the final outcome, the drama will have a far-reaching impact on other sports like boxing, wrestling, swimming, cycling, weightlifting, where speed and power are crucial to success. Santhi Soundarajan is another Indian athlete with elevated testosterone levels.
As we move towards an acceptance of gender fluidity, this ruling is trying to narrow down what it means to be a woman.
Both Semenya and Duti Chand have female rather than male partners, giving further credence to the manliness factor in women with higher testosterone levels. Already, athletes transitioning from female to male can compete without restriction, but those transiting from male to female cannot transition again for at least 4 years and must suppress their testosterone levels to below 300 for a year before becoming eligible for the Olympics. It's probably time to create another category for athletes across all sports, DSD. The disputed ruling, instead of answering a question, has asked several more. This is only the first of the coming challenges on gender identity. What happens when genetically modified babies grow up to be super athletes? Bisbo's limerick. Caster Semenya was banned from running a race. They say elevated testosterone gave her a superior pace. But not all agree to let Semenya run free. There are surely two sides to this complex case. Subscribe to Bisbo's channel and be sure to click on the bell icon. Be the first to know when Bisbo releases a new video.